I'd say this is a fantastic H-string if you've never tried an H-string before and you wanted to get into some H-string playing. I think it's good, high quality, well built. TD make very quality instruments right across the board, actually. So if you're thinking of getting an H-string and you've never tried one before, definitely get your hands on one of these, definitely, for sure. It's solid. I would recommend that possibly anybody who tries it out to change the string straight away, so maybe get a bigger gauge F sharp string. This feels like a 60 or a 50. I think it should be at least about a 70, just to get it a bit more resistance. So at the moment, this is tuned a standard 8 string tuning, so we have F sharp and B, and then we have E, A, D, G, B, E as usual. So basically it's just a continuation of a 7 string, so you have the B, then you have a low F sharp. And you can also drop the F sharp. To an E. And you can get a lower note. So you can do lots of, if you're into jazz as well, you can do a lot of jazz chord voicing with walking bass lines, if that's your bag. I'm not going to demonstrate that though. But yeah, there's so many tuning options, because obviously if you have those many tunings on a 6 string, just imagine how many you can get out of an 8 string. But I'd say drop E and standard are the most common tunings for an 8 string guitar. So if you take our usual kind of box power chord and then carrying it on is a good place to start. So you could take your power chord, lower strings, then you can add your third, so, or you take that third out, make it a minor chord. You could even try different sevenths, so you could try major seventh, fifth, seventh, third. Try. So just try, just have an experiment of different chords that you're familiar with on the 6th string, and just try them on the bottom 4 strings. Then I'd also experiment trying to figure out your scales and arpeggios. Maybe let's try this is going to be a B major scale. And also learning, figuring out how to create longer arpeggios. So. Thank you. wowie kind of sound. And even better, if you drop that to E. You can have, just like with a drop D on a guitar or drop A on a 7 string, you have a power chord in the lower. And then you can get really filthy kind of sounds. It makes you, if you're writing music, it, you know, if you pick up a 6 string, you wouldn't write something that you'd write on an 8 string. And that's not just because there's more strings, it's just the options that you have. You know, you don't have to use all 8 strings. I mean, you could use it like a 6 string, and by adding in those 7th and 8th strings into your compositions, you can create different effects, and different, you know, layers and different dynamics. So, you know, it's not all about just chugging on the lower strings. You know, there's a whole 8 strings there to be had. So there's lots of potential for new ideas. Okay, I'd recommend that people check out a band called Animals as Leaders. They use 8-string guitars. There's a guitarist called Toes and Abasi in that band, and he does lots of different tunings. I'd also check out a UK-based band called Monuments. They use 8-string guitars in a sort of dadgad style tuning. And also, I'd say they're like Periphery. Is another band that popularised 8 strings, but I think mainly the reason why we are 8 strings are kind of available now is a band called Meshuggah, who use very large 8 strings and they tune them even lower than a standard F sharp. And definitely check out all those bands for different styles of 8 string playing. And my band, of course, use 8 strings, Mask of Judas, so you definitely need to check that out. But each of these bands, everyone has, because it's such a unique instrument and it's kind of, it's not new, but it is kind of new. So there's a lot of people trying out completely different things, and there's always going to be lots of different things you can do in those strings. So Mask of Judas.